psycho. Yellow, Lonnie. Hut, hut.
Up the middle they go. Griffin. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game. The game's first play produces 6 yards. Brings up second down.
Ready. Ultra. Go Ultra. Striker. 3-3. Check pick. Set hut.
They'll keep it on the ground. It's Griffin. And a good push there defensively as they stop him at the 48. Gain of just one. Now this defense for the Lions, very strong last week as they helped their squad improve to 2-0 on the young season.
And the big difference in the ball game, their ability to force turnovers, 3 of them in fact. Being able to take the ball away, give it back to their offense, that's something that's emphasized each and every
week.
Here we go. They carried it out.
Third play of this opening drive as they're looking at a 3rd and 3.
Set.
On 3rd down, Griffin. And he has the first
Ready,
down
set.
As he's able to reach the ball forward and get past the line to gain. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter.
Smash, red. Set.
Now a play fake here on 1st down. And incomplete on the deep ball. The Packers at 1-1 through 2 games thus far. It's not a start that's going to set the world on fire, but they've been pretty solid nonetheless.
And the first thing that crosses my mind is certainly beats the alternative of starting 0-2. I do think that this is a team that's going to take a little time to find its footing. Hard to navigate the always tough NFL.
Let's go.
2nd and 10.
Blaster, 6. Drill green. Ready.
Throwing again. McCall. The left side completion to Jones. They do get a yard there, but only a yard. Leaves them with 3rd and 9 looming.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get out to your running back, and it could turn into a big gain downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short game.
Ready.
And they'll need the 39 here for a first.
Hey, go steal.
Down.
Spike, White. Go Ray!
In motion right, Dobbs.
Red, cycle. Blue, striker. Ready?
They just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. I had a man open, but he missed him, and it's incomplete.
Had an open man that time, but ended up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely. Just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet. And he was called on 3 times in the win last week as his first one here's away. With it is Jackson. They'll score that a 36-yard punt, and the Lions will take over. the streets of Green Bay. No tall buildings, quaint houses. And then, boom, right there in the middle of the neighborhood is iconic Lambeau Field. Today, it's week three, and we've got a good one in store, as it'll be the Detroit Lions taking on the Green Bay Packers. The final weekend of the summer. Hope you're enjoying it wherever you are, as we are off and running on EA Sports. And no return here to start. It's a fair catch, and they will set up shop at the 25.
Ready. Black Ultra. Ready.
Throwing to start the drive. McCall. Oh, he had a man running free, but he overshot him, and it's incomplete. Christian Watson, the man he was looking for.
And that'll bring up second down.
You talk about this Lions defense.
They played extremely well last week in the win over Atlanta.
And the big difference in the game, their ability to force turnovers. Multiple, in fact. Being able to take the ball away, give it back to their offense, the big difference in the game.
It was impressive. Now the question, can they duplicate it?
Claws, 10. Hey, go Fury. Steel, black.
He'll try again with the arm here on second down. And this one is incomplete.
This defense has passed its first two tests by forcing back-to-back incompletions. They know that there's probably another throw coming on third down. Let's see if they decide to force the issue by sending people on a blitz.
Ready.
Incompletions have led him to an early third and 10.
Shovel, 38. Fury, yellow. 6, mega.
The offense knew it. They were already starting to walk back as that one is accepted.
Got it.
After the delay, they're backed up even further for third and long.
Black shock. Claws red. Slice blue. Green jack.
And boy, again, they won't get this off in time. So they accept the penalty, of course, and push the offense backwards a bit.
Down.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down.
Ready, go.
Back to throw. McCall caught on the right side. Reed. And he'll be brought down at the 28, and that is well short of the first. They get 13, but it's not nearly enough. And it'll be fourth down. On now is the Packers punter. He'll kick it away after a three and out on the opening drive of the game. Here's Jackson. It's a return of four following a 42-yard punt. And they will take over first and 10.
Ready.
we step aside here in this first quarter.
Come on, come on,
check. First and 10 now from the 33.
Ready.
Flag comes in. This might be a free play. And he'll get this up to about the 40. Even with the good gain, I thought they might accept that one.
Yeah, you thought maybe they'd go with the downs as opposed to the yardage. So if you're taking the yardage now,
here we go, here we go.
That tells me you feel good about how your offense is working.
Cowboy 80. 18, Pioneer.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. His throw incomplete. You look at this Packers defense, and they played well against the pass, currently ranked 7th in the NFL.
And I'm struggling a little bit trying to really categorize this crew. They're top 10 in the league against the pass, but the bottom half of the league in sacking the quarterback. That doesn't make sense. Imagine if this group ever put pressure on the QB, they'd easily move into the top 5.
Check, Bobcat, check, Bobcat. Ready?
He's got it to Williams. And he appears to be about 2 feet short on 3rd and 3. Leaves him with a 4th and 1. On 4th down, Jack Fox on to punt for Detroit. And that one hits at the 7, but bounds into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway.
Red, yellow.
Now, early on, you know, Charles, every game could be called a measuring stick game. But I think when it comes within your division like this, it's a measuring stick game with a little extra intrigue.
I would agree with that totally because all division games have a little extra to them. But I like where this game is situated because at this stage.
Oh, he tries to force it in and it's intercepted. Brandon Jones picking it off. And the return will be stopped at the 34-yard line. The rookie was trying to push it downfield, but the safety bit him.
And he'll learn that you have to hold the safety. And you do that with your head movement, your eyes, sometimes your shoulders. Hold the safety so that you can get back to the throw that you really want to make. He got so excited thinking his guy was open that he made it easy for the defensive back to go get the football.
79 Broncos, 19 Lions, take go.
They'll come out throwing here on first down. And that's incomplete.
No sense risking anything there on first down. Even though he's still in the pocket, he had a receiver out to his side, so just put that in a spot where the only people who could make a play on it are the trainers and the coaches. Well done.
Here we go,
now it's 2nd and 10.
Kirk, Kirk! Go!
Gibbs straight ahead. 5 yards, now it's 3rd and 5. Well, this defense for the Packers, much improved from week one. They were terrific last week in getting their guys their first win of the season.
And as in any game, takeaways are always a big key. They're always discussed on defense. There's an emphasis there. And they came away with three interceptions in that game.
70 Lions. Big Lion.
On 3rd down, here's Gibbs. And he'll be out of bounds just inside the 25-yard line. Call it sticks. Last week, of course, the great performance, over 200 yards. He still wants to be fed.
And they should.
Let's go now.
That's exactly what you should do. I've not yet met a running back that's run for over 200 yards that says the very next week, hey, let's back
up. Yeah, I don't need it as much.
No, they want it more and more. They're going to be ready to go because they think that's going to happen naturally now.
That's going to go as a loss of six, and it'll set them back for second down.
Six. Check smash, check smash. Ready, ready.
Straight ahead with Gibbs here. Might have gotten this one down to the 28, and that's all. They get just a yard back there, and now they'll be looking at a tough third and 15.
Early down stuff to put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big-bodied guys in the middle of this day, has got to be priority one.
Ready!
A tough spot here. Third and 15.
Streak!
In
streak!
Motion left, that's Jackson.
Buffalo 18! Dragon 60! Ready!
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And the throw there gonna be incomplete.
Going to hurt a bit because they needed to come through with a completion there. Now a drive that started with great field position is facing fourth down.
That is inches from the upright. It's no good. Wide to the left.
Always disappointing when you miss a field goal, but when you're playing against a defense this good, you and I both know that's a crucial miss because you can't afford to leave any points out there. You've got to take them when you can.
Okay,
about
right?
Set to get this drive Traster, started. Six. The Green Bay offense at the line. And for this offense, Charles, you got to think kind of crucial here to put something together on
mega,
this drive.
Mega.
Because remember last time out, they threw the interception on the very first play.
And you can't afford to let this defense keep building any more momentum. They're playing awfully well, and they're awfully confident right now. To me, it's time to attack and take some of that momentum back. But make sure you're selective in doing so. Understand where you want to throw the football and make sure it's open before the ball leaves your hands.
Second and six at the 39-yard line.
Here we go.
39-yard line. Here comes second down and six.
Drill green. 22 needle. Hut. Go.
And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. Now they're going to be dealing with a third and seven. Is that one officially a loss of one?
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for. One of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
Okay, ready?
Now third down and seven.
Spike, white. Red, cycle. Blue, striker. Hut, hut.
Looking to throw. McCall. All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Brandon Jones picking it off, and the Lions are going to take over at their own 41.
And Brandon, how many times have we talked with these rookies out there, and then we finally hear from them that the game slowed down and they're able to handle things? Not so far for this rookie, because right now, back-to-back drives, they picked him off. Not college football anymore. He's got
ready,
a way
set
to handle what these defenses throw at him.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. They'll start in excellent field position following
the
INT.
Hey, check that. Street.
Hut. Drive starts with a run from Gibbs. And he'll be taken down at about the 45.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. Wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
AT Rattler. Ready?
Second and six. They'll let this go deep for St. Brown. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
Zone coverage there, and they were playing deep. That makes it obviously a little bit harder to run by guys. And that time, there was not much of a window to get the ball in there, and it winds up incomplete.
Shot.
So after the second down incompletion, they'll come up now against a third and six.
Check smash. Check smash.
Motion left.
70 Ranger. Chop 60. Check go.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. Oh, he had him. He was open, but he couldn't get it to him. It's incomplete.
How about the show put on by these two defenses in this first half? The fireworks don't have to be just offensively. Neither one of them giving an inch, and that's good coverage once again there to force another fourth down.
And this one hits at the three and then bounds into the end zone for a touchback.
Ready.
Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And partner, I know so far, and we're still in the first half, but you love this
that
game
cut.
As a defensive guy. 0-0. We'll see if the offense can get going on this drive.
But you know how they talk about music to your ears? How about what it does for your eyes when you watch something like this, right? Where these teams are locked in and going at it. No points going up on the scoreboard. I'm loving it. You're exactly right.
Well, switch over, though, to an offensive mindset for a moment. What do they need to do here to get on track and get some points?
Well, I think a couple of ways. Number one, you pull out something maybe they haven't seen before. Coach is always talking about unscouted looks. Maybe you give them something that they haven't seen on tape, and now you shock them that way. The second, run your basic playbook, but run it so well that you give your skill position guys a chance to make big plays individually.
Here we go.
So
set.
A first and 10 at the 38.
On the ball. Blue check.
No score after one on EA Sports. Back for the second quarter in Green Bay. It's the Packers in possession of the football as they've got it with a first and 10.
Come on, set. Black Ultra. Steel Black. 52 Blaster. Set.
They'll keep it on the ground. It's Griffin. And a good physical run that time. He's going to wind up gaining 5 on that one. The Packers at 1-1 through two games thus far. And they were winners their last time out, so they'll be looking to make it 2 in a row.
And so much about football, partner, comes down to mindset. Being in the right frame of mind, and the best way to get in that good frame of mind, winning. So they come in feeling good. They've got the home crowd behind them. And I think they're going to be tough to beat in this one.
Here we go.
Second and 5.
Ready.
Now here's a little touch pass as they tap it quickly to their receiver. And he's out of bounds just before the midfield stripe at the 49. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
And this is just a little touch pass. They send the receiver in motion, just kind of tap it forward. to him. Now, it doesn't turn into a huge play, but they do pick up a first down, a nice consistent gain.
On the ready.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10.
Yellow, zoom. Ready.
Now a handoff up the middle. Griffin, and he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
Set.
Now they contend with a second and 12 after the loss. Fury,
yellow. Striker. Six, mega. 43 rail. Ready.
Up the middle they go. It's Griffin on a determined run there as he's going to take this all the way down near the 40. It's a gain of 12, and the Packers have the first.
That's how you get right up off of the mat, because on the last play, they stoned him in the backfield and dropped him for a loss. But he's the type of guy that scared me a little bit, because he's not daunted. Just got right back
on the double,
showed some confidence, and picked up a first down with his very next run.
Yellow, go.
Send a receiver in motion to the left.
Hut.
On first down, Griffin. And dropped at the 35, but able to display some strength on the run.
Offensive linemen love creating space for their guys carrying the ball, but when that guy also breaks tackles and creates extra yardage, they almost feel like he's one of them, and they really embrace him.
Let's go.
From the 35, back to work on second and 4.
Shock, 17. Ready, go.
They'll keep it on the ground. It's Griffin, and this time not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
Ready.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10.
Watch out now, 50 Fury.
Now an audible here into something else. They'll run on first down. Griffin, a short gain here, maybe a yard to the 29.
He's had success on this drive, but not on this play.
Finally, they bowed up defensively. I think they were determined not to let him take it pretty much all the way down the field.
Yeah, it looks like they handled their run responsibilities correctly this time. What we call them, run fits, everyone was in the right place.
Ready.
Now second and 9.
Needle blue. Smith red. Slice, 97. Set, go.
A handoff up the middle. It's Griffin, and that one blown up quickly, as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. That's a big loss of 3, and it brings up third down.
But they're certainly not neglecting their run duties as well, as they ate up the blockers in front and allowed the secondary to get home.
Let's go now.
Third and 12.
Black shock. Hey, green. Hey, go.
Off the play fake. McCall. It's incomplete. Took a
What did we talk with them about prior to the game? Their ability to move the chains, pick up first downs. So far, 0 for 3 on third down. If that continues, they'll have little chance of winning this one.
And his kick is indeed good, and the Packers are off to a 3-0 lead. So they're able to end that drive with 3 points in this one possession ball game.
And ideally, you want to end every drive with points. Most quarterbacks would tell you, let's end it with a kick, right? A PAT, that's number one. Field goal, you'll take. Punts, you really don't want to do that. In this case, they'll take the field goal and get prepared for the rest of the game.
The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. Still in the first half, but this offense has struggled. Haven't really been able to get anything going, not only in the points category, but in the yards category. We'll see if they can do better here on this drive.
Hurk! Hurk! Right there, Hurk! Check! Hurk! Hurk! Go!
To the outside, that's complete to Williams.
Ready, ready!
Maybe a good spot to take a shot. Here, second and a yard from the 34.
Go, Chap! Go, Chap! Hut.
Finding Williams once more, complete. Third catch of this first half for him, and this one is a first down.
Come on,
like
come on,
the wide receiver screen, because it's a real teamwork play. Because guess what? The guy catching the ball, he'll get all the credit. How about the people up to block in front of him, either fellow receivers or offensive linemen? That makes that play a really nice timing play, and sometimes it can break big. Give credit to the defense for
here we
stringing
go, here
that
we go.
Play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through.
Cougar 19,
no place for him to
60
go.
Bobcat,
nice
60 Bobcat.
Giving up a 3-yard gain.
Ready, right?
The play action fake, they'll look to throw. Packer pressure, and down he goes.
Hurry, hurry!
They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also third down.
70, Timberwolf! Warrior, 70! Ready!
Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. And that is incomplete.
As a corner, you have to be able to run with guys step for step downfield in man coverage and make up ground quickly in zone. You have to put yourself in position to make plays just like that one we saw there.
And here now the punter Fox as he sends this one away. That'll be a 43-yard punt, but a net of just 33 following a 10-yard return. And it'll be Packer football here. First down and 10. About set to get this drive started. The Green Bay offense at the line. And not an abundance of time remains on the clock, Charles, but you think more than enough to try to extend this lead before intermission.
And when you're talking about extending the lead, I think you're talking about aiming for the end zone because there is plenty of time for that. The fallback is to get 3. But in your mind, you put 6 on the board right before the half. That's a heck of a dagger and great momentum to carry into the locker room.
The loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a 2nd and 11.
Set, cut.
Completed out left to Dobbs. 9 yards, not quite enough, but they'll be left now with 3rd and 1. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 35 seconds to go in quarter number 2. 3rd down and 1.
Steal. check steal. Claws red. Slice blue. Set.
Operating from the gun. McCall. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Chauncey Gardner-Johnson with a pick. And the Lions are going to take over a couple of yards shy of midfield. Certainly not what he was hoping for, Charles. That's now three interceptions in this ball game.
But there's a lot of knowledge to be gleaned every time you throw an interception if you do things the right way. And hasn't there been a pretty darn good quarterback along the way who threw a lot of interceptions early, learned from them, and became great later?
Who would that be?
That'd be one Peyton Manning. Threw 28 his rookie year. That's the NFL record. How'd things turn out for him?
I think okay. He's a guy in all the commercials now, right?
Yeah, I think he's doing okay.
Got it. Ready?
The Lions offense 60 ready Maverick. To kick 60 off their Maverick. Next drive. And with great starting field position and a couple of timeouts at their disposal, they'll certainly have the green light here. Into the hands of Williams across the formation.
Hurry!
Like they're gonna be in the
Panther 11! Panther 11!
Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see.
Ready?
So here's a first and 10 at the 38.
Cup 19! 19 tight! Ready?
Back to throw. He gets it complete to Jackson. And we're going to get a timeout with 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
Patterson's kick is good, and that will do it for this first half. And that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Second half ready to roll. 2 field goals, the combined output in half number one. Could be first touchdown wins.
Let's go.
The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. It's a tie football game here.
Panther
what do you
Street.
Think, Charles, the
Panther
message
Street.
Was at halftime?
Check out.
Well, I think that they probably just looked at things and said, we're fortunate that this is a tie game. No need to panic. No need to change a whole lot. We didn't play anything close to our best in the first half, so we don't have to go out and win one for the Gipper. Let's just go out and play our best football and win one for us.
Okay, break.
From the 32-yard line here, 2nd and 3.
Go.
They're going to look to throw. Setting up the screen, this is Gibbs. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. So a roughing the passer penalty there, CD.
And we know that these pass rushers love to get after rookie quarterbacks, but they've still got to do it within the scope of the rules. And that time, the hit came just a little bit
smash
too late.
Bronco!
And the official wanted to think twice about pulling his flag on that one.
A quick throw there out to Williams. And to the 36-yard line, taken down there after getting 8 yards.
When you call a wide receiver screen, no matter how many blockers you get in front of the guy that catches the ball, there's still an aspect of the guy catching it, turning into a runner, breaking tackles, and creating his own yardage, and he just did on that play.
Oh, that's into a double team, and it's intercepted. And the return across midfield and to the 46-yard line. That time defensively looked like they showed quite a bit of pressure, but backed off, and it proved fruitful. They get the pick.
He He saw all those people stacked at the line of scrimmage, and then they fooled him by dropping into coverage. Now he's ready to get rid of the ball fast, but guess what? Too many defenders out there. Exactly as you described, an interception.
Green Jack. Check smash. Rail, yellow. Set.
Throwing to start the drive. Call. They'll complete this one to watch. And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. That good for 21 yards on the catch and run. Right after the turnover, they come out throwing.
And that means it's a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change, get out there, stop the offense. But you typically run out there a little bit unsettled.
Set, ready.
That's why he came right out throwing the football, hoping to catch him off balance.
And he did.
Blue, go.
The center receiver in motion to the right.
Drill, 52.
Now a whistle and I think a penalty here for a delay. No, they're going to say timeout. They did get the timeout in time. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter.
Here we go, set. Ready, ready.
Now the ball comes loose. Look at this, middle of the field, a breakaway. And this will be gathered up in the end zone. That's a defensive touchdown. So many times, tight games decided by one big play. And a lot of times, of course, it's the offense. Here, it's the defense coming up huge.
And you know, head coaches walk around locker rooms, walk around bench areas saying, guys, somebody make a play. It's a cliche, but it applies here.
Extra point by Patterson, up and good. And the lead is now 10-3. And Patterson back out there to send this one away. And he'll elect not to run with it. And the fair catch on the kickoff will move the ball to the 25.
Come on, set!
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And Charles, they're certainly still right in this game, but they need that offense to wake up and in a hurry.
Yeah, I like the way you put it. They certainly did seem to sleepwalk a bit in the first half. Now that their defense has done its job, it's their turn now to go out and try and get some points.
Throwing to start the drive. McCall. And a big loss here as he's taken down.
Hustle.
Now this one from about two counties after the sack. They
Blaster,
come up on a second and very
striker.
Long.
Check striker. Ready.
Back to throw. McCall. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Chauncey Gardner-Johnson with a pick. And he'll get this back to the 32-yard line. Boy, you just kind of feel for him right now. Four interceptions, and you can almost see through his face mask. There's a lot going on in between the ears.
There certainly
there we go.
Is, and probably way too much, because now he's probably doubting himself a little bit, wondering what adjustments he has to make. But here's what he needs to do.
Go.
Get through this game.
Ready, ready?
Go to the press conference. Meet it head on and show your teammates you're ready to shoulder what happened today.
Now, faster,
and you'll
faster.
Be ready for the next game.
And if he can do that as a rookie, that's a great sign of maturity.
Check, Bobcat. Check, Bobcat. Ready?
Another run for Gibbs here. And he's got this pretty close to a first down as the tackle is made at the Packers 24. And now they're in the hurry up.
Hurt, hurt. Street, street.
Gibbs will try and pick it up. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Detroit. Jimmy Gibbs. His fifth rush.
rushing touchdown now on the year, and the Lions have taken a 2-touchdown lead now.
Yeah, they would have been happy with a first down, but this is even better. Once he's past the marker, it's cream cheese from there, and he bumps it to the outside, and it's just going to run away from defenders on his way toward the pylon.
And he pushed it right. It's no good. Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. Fair catch going to be taken, and this will be moved out to the 25.
Ready up.
About set to get this drive started. The Green Bay offense at the line. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together and say, all right, guys, we're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track.
Here we go. Here we go.
In the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them. Not necessarily to look at your plays. Oh, this hurts the defense. I want the ball in the hands of X, Y, and Z and see if we can move forward.
So don't get too cute. Go to the playmakers. And a penalty accepted, and they move the ball
on the
forward.
Set. Ready, ready. Check Fury. Hut, hut.
They go play action here on first down. Caught here by Griffin. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Rookie quarterback, rookie running back. They team up there to pick up the
ultra,
first.
Ultra. Set, go.
Off play action. McCall goes right back to him. It's Griffin again.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack.
Black swap.
A lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
And under the Lions' pressure, he's
brought down. Jackrabbit.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down.
10 cycles.
Now they'll change things up.
Drill green. Hey, check mega. Spike, white. Hut, hut.
To throw on third down, McCall. He's going to launch this deep for Watson. That's caught inside the 20. Touchdown, Packers. Christian Watson, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Packers have got it back to within a score. Anders Carlson now for the point after. And it's up. This is good, and it makes it a 16-10 game now. Back out there now to send this one away. But no run back here. Fair catch, and this will come out to the 25. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. Still enjoying the lead here in the third quarter despite their
Big
defense
Lion.
Giving up that last touchdown. We'll see if they can get the equalizer here on this drive. A good gain there on first down. That run will get them seven up to the 32-yard line.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
They'll go again with Gibbs. And he'll lose yardage here. Going down.
On the ball, on
the
ball, now, now.
And they're going to speed things up here.
Check smash, check smash. Go.
Now that'll be caught by St. Brown. down, but he winds up taking a pretty good shot that time. They give him 7 yards on the play, and they do pick up the conversion on third down. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. On first and 10, here's Gibbs. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. He stayed afloat for a second there after the first wave of contact, but that was going nowhere.
Yeah, what did he tell us in pregame? I just don't want to get my feet stopped initially when I'm trying to make a run. That's exactly what happened there. Unfortunately, as you noted, got away.
Hey, check that, check that. Street, street.
The wave swarmed him under.
Second down, and they go back to Gibbs. And this Green Bay defense making that play look a lot like the previous one. Both tackles behind the line of scrimmage. So they'll get a little extra time to come up with this third down play as we played three quarters. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports.
Let's go now.
The Lions on third down.
Seven Pirates.
Three for
seven Pirates.
So far in this game. This is third and 17.
Mustang 19. Ready, ready.
He'll look to throw. The throw here, right sideline, falls incomplete. Critical play in this football game because if they pick up the first there, that clock keeps rolling.
Has to be a little frustrating for them because they know that if they pick up a first down there and continue to eat away at the clock, really increases their chances of closing this one out. Now they're likely going to have to give the football up and sweat it out on the sideline.
To return is McKenzie. That'll go as a 46-yard punt with a return of 7. And it will be first and 10 as they take over.
Ready.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And you sense the tide turning. They scored, then their defense forced the punt, and now a chance to ultimately take the lead here late.
Set, hut.
Off the play fake. McCall. And this throw a bit late as he couldn't reach back for it.
Well, this at least is the right idea. I think they've got to get the tight end more involved.
He had just one target in the first half, incomplete. Now incomplete here with the first target of the second half.
Yeah, should not stop them at all from going back to him, though. Find him. Find him.
Ready, ready.
Here's second and 10.
Blue striker. Set.
To throw again. McCall. And now here is another interception. Chauncey Gardner-Johnson with a pick. And the Lions are going to have the short field here as they'll take over right at the 50. And you have to wonder, Charles, a game like this, 5 interceptions, what does this do to the psyche of a young quarterback?
Well, based on the fact that he's still out there and he threw a 5th interception, I'm wondering if his head coach believes that he's really strong mentally and wants him to play through it. Because otherwise, you need to get him out and fight another day because this could leave lasting damage if he keeps throwing interceptions.
Kirk! Kirk! Right there! Ready!
Counterplay. Here's Gibbs. Taking it right down Broadway. East to the 15. Touchdown, Detroit! Jahmyr Gibbs with his second TD of the game, his 6th on the year. And the Lions are closing in on a 3rd straight win as they widen the gap further here in the 4th quarter. We talk so often about how hard it is to win in the NFL when you turn the ball over and...